Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in this series on Django fundamentals, where we'll be looking at the concept of Django templates. Okay, so let's get started. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to create a templates folder in our project's root directory. So here we're in Taskly, our project. I can right click, so just right click on it, new folder, and I'm going to call this templates. So basically, all our HTML files will be in our templates folder. So we'll be rendering HTML templates, okay, instead of the JSON response, which we have used in the previous videos. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we need to configure our templates directory with Django. So to do that, we need to go to settings.py. Let's remove this. Now, what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to, like I said before, tell Django where to find our template. Okay, and to do that, we need to join our base directory with our templates folder. So to do that, we need to first import a module called OS. Okay, and we need to scroll down a bit until we see the templates configuration settings. And you'll see here we have something called DIRS and an empty list here. So what we're going to do is very straightforward. We're just simply going to say os.parse.join, and in parentheses, we're going to say base dir, which is our base directory, and we want to join that to our templates folder. So basically, like I said, we're telling Django where to find our templates, so it's going to look in our base directory here, and then specifically under templates. Okay, so this is where we're going to store all our HTML pages, like index.html, register.html, login.html, simply like that. And we can refer to that, like I said, as HTML templates. So this is perfect. So we've configured templates now. Now let's actually create a simple HTML template and render it out instead of a HTTP response. So let's close this up. And let's see what we have at the moment. So let's go to our to-do app. Let's look at our view. And under our home view, we are returning a HTTP response. And we can see it just says here, this is our home page. Very straightforward and simple. But what we want to do is we want to swap this out and render. So we have the render function here. We want to render an index.html page. So a HTML page. So to do that, we want to go to templates. Create a new file, and I'm going to call it index.html. Okay, and now I'm just going to add some text. You can write whatever, so a basic HTML here. So I'm going to say, this is our website. And I'm going to just put another tag here saying, this is the best website on the planet. Okay, a little bit of exaggeration here. So this is our HTML template, which we've created under our templates directory. And we want to now render this. So like usual, we go to our views. And I just want to actually move this view up top because it doesn't look so great here. So I just want to under here, instead of returning a HTTP response, I'm going to render this template. So I'm going to take this out. And I'm going to say return render. And we need to pass in two parameters for now. So request, and we want to render out our index.html page. So since we told Django to look in the templates directory for our templates, we don't need to say templates forward slash. We can just say index.html. So there we go. So what we may need to do first is just restart our server. So just run it up again. Okay, and just double check and refresh, and there we go. So this is our simple HTML template, which we have just rendered. Okay, so this is how, of course, how we configure a template and also how we render it. So we can see now that we're not rendering a HTTP response anymore. It's now our template, which we created here. So this is our website. This is the best website on the planet. And we can see it's been rendered out successfully. So hopefully this gives you a bit more insight in understanding the concept of templates. All right, great. Now, another thing I want to teach you is on template inheritance. So The template inheritance, basically what we'll be doing is we are, you could say, in normal terms, we are inheriting characteristics from a file, you could say. So let me show you simply how it goes. So I have my register view and I have my login view here. So let's say I want to create two more templates here for a register HTML template and a my login HTML template. So let's do that. So I'm just going to create two more templates and I'm going to call it register.html. And I'm going to say this one my login.html. So I'm just going to keep this very simple here. So I don't want to make it confusing. So let's see what we have here. So I'm just going to make this a bit more appropriate. I'm going to say this is our homepage. Okay, I just want to refresh. Okay, that's looking good. So what we can do now is I want to look for something that I can reuse. So what can I reuse? This is the best website on the planet. Okay, this is a good thing. So we can put this on every single page here, but let's just customize our register page here. So let's say this is our registration page. Okay. I'm going to say here, this is our login page. Okay, there we go. And now we can replace out those old JSON responses. We can take them out. Take this out. And we can just copy here the render function and just lead it to register.html and mylogin.html. So make sure that your template names here are exactly as you specified here. Even the extension, make sure you add that. So register is simply register here. My login is got my and then dash login, like that. So let's just turn off the server, rerun it just in case. So if we go back, okay, this there wasn't much change here to the homepage. Now let's go to register. Okay, now we are rendering a HTML template for the registration page. And my login, what was my login? The URL, I think it was wrong one. Yeah, this is our route. So it was the same. Okay, there we go. So we can see all three of our pages, our homepage, our registration page, and our login page is all rendering templates now. So we can go back to how it was in the beginning. And there we go. Okay, so we've had now a bit more practice with our templates. Okay, so let's close this all up. Okay, now what we want to do now is we have our three HTML templates, which renders out our three views, which is on the homepage, the login page, and the registration page. Now we want to do something called template inheritance. So basically, we're going to create a, we can give this any name we want. So I'm going to call this base.html. And this is going to be pretty much like a basic sort of component or section that we want to inherit on all our HTML templates. Okay, so this can be, you can call this, for example, navbar. So this stands for navigation bar. And technically, you could make your own navigation bar here, and you can include it on all your other templates, and they'll all share the same style and contents of this navbar that you created here. Now, this gets, of course, this is obviously very important when you get onto full stack development, when you are dealing with decoupling your front end and your back end. So the concept here of you could say it's not inheritance but reusing components. Okay, so this is pretty much this very similar in Django, but let's not make it too complicated, and let's just call this for now base.html. And I want to reuse stuff from base.html in my other templates. So I want to reuse this h4 tag that says this is the best website on the planet. And I want to put in hr, which is a line. So if I check, Okay, there we go. So I'm going to simply copy this here, put it in base.html, like that. There we go. Okay, and I can take this out. Okay, and I'm going to include everything from this HTML in my other template. So to do that, let's close this up. I'm going to put this actually at the top of all of them, and I'm going to just create something called a tag. So to use a tag, you can just put a curly brace, percentage sign, and say include. And here we need to put in the name, which is base.html. And closing percentage sign was a curly brace. Okay, so if I were to refresh, it's going to say this is the best website on the planet. Now we have inherited from our base.html. This is called template inheritance. Now let's do that to our other HTML templates. Okay, so we have some consistency, so I can just copy this here. Save. Okay, that's the one done. Register. There we go. Template. My login. Template inheritance. So you can basically see here the potential of template inheritance. So imagine if this were a navbar, it looked pretty nice and very good with managing consistency. Okay. So that is template inheritance. Okay. So just remember, these are tags that we have created, and we'll get further and in more detail with tags and so as we move on. Okay, so in this lesson, I hope that this made sense to you. So we've learned how to configure templates with Django, how to render a simple template, and also how to perform template inheritance. Okay, so that's it.